Morning. Hello, everybody. Welcome. We're just waiting for everybody to join us and get settled into our session. We'll be starting shortly.
Good morning. Welcome. Welcome to DigCit Connect. Hello.
Good morning. Good morning.
So nice to see so many people. Thank you for joining our breakout session. This is Digital Presence with Purpose. It's an administrator session for the DigCit Connect breakouts. We'll get started shortly. If you want to type into the chat where you're from, that would be great to give us a little bit of an idea of who you are and where you're coming from.
Yes.
Are we signing in?
No sign in. Just the beginning of the session earlier is the only sign in required. Thank you for asking and welcome to everybody. And as Jamie mentioned, go ahead, let us know where you're joining from today. We're just going to get started in just a minute. Once we get settled, we have about, our numbers keep growing, so we have some people joining, but in just a moment, we'll get started. Thanks again for joining our session, Digital Presence with Purpose. And again, this is a session intended for school site and district administrators and DigCit leaders. So thank you for joining us this afternoon or morning, depending on where you're joining us from. See lots of LAUSD peeps. Welcome. See recognizable names and faces. Yeah. And welcome from out of the state as well. So excited to see lots of others from other areas joining us today. So Jamie, I think we're ready to get started. What do you say?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's do it. So welcome once again to Digital Presence with Purpose. Jamie and I are presenting this morning for DigCit Connect. We'll go ahead and introduce ourselves in just a minute, but we're going to move on to our next slide and just kind of go over some virtual meeting tips for today. Please take a look at our tips here to ensure your connectivity is optimal for our session. And then in the chat, Jamie has just dropped the link to the DigCit Connect event page where you can get back to all of your itinerary after the session and view the program schedule, and then also the bit.ly for the direct link to our slides that we're going to go over this during this time. I want to say this morning, but I know not everybody is in AM right now, depending on where you're joining from. So, all right. And again, no sign-in is needed for today. Hello, I am Maria Magnanimo-Toledo, Readiness and Integration Specialist with the Los Angeles Unified School District, and my co-facilitator.
Hi, I'm Jamie Galgana. Thank you, Maria. So nice to see you all. I am Jamie. I'm an Instructional Leadership Support Specialist. Really excited to be joining you all today. Just to clarify, someone did ask if this is only for administrators. It's also open to our education leaders. So everyone is welcome here. Just adjust the content as needed to fit your personal role.
All right. Absolutely. We did just want to mention that so you are aware of whether this will meet your needs. If you think it's not during the session, feel free to check out something other than this. But that's the intent of our session. So moving on to the agenda now, we're going to quickly do a few opening activities just after this. Then we'll move into some grounding around our DigCit LA presence. And then we'll have plenty of time for exploration and application of your DigCit LA, your digital presence. And then we will just wrap up with some closing activities. So moving right along, I do want to invite everybody to make your mark during our session today. Please be bold, be active, be collaborative, and let everyone know about your learning. On the next slide, we have some recommended hashtags. If you would like to tag us, we are ITI, at ITI underscore LAUSD. That stands for the Instructional Technology Initiative of the LAUSD. And we have lots of local district hashtags and other hashtags that we would suggest that you add to your tweet. And at the end, we'll also give you a direct link to tweet. So be on the lookout for that. On our next slide, just want to take a minute to cover our objectives. So today, this is what we hope to accomplish. We want to help you gain insights into system level policies and practices that support digital citizenship. We also want to take you on a deep dive into a framework for leveraging digital presence and engagement. And then we also want to support you in exploring ways to explore and develop a plan aligned to your district's digital citizenship policies and professional learning. As we work through today, for the next hour, please consider this guiding question. How might we create an inclusive and equitable culture of digital citizenship as education leaders? And thank you, Jamie. We'll go ahead now and move right along into our next activity. And so I think that we'll just go right into this, Jamie. It looks like one of our slides got hidden, but yes?
Yes, sorry about that. I don't know
why. Okay, or you're gonna try to reset it. Okay, so right now we're going to engage in a very quick inclusion activity where we use our annotation tool. So as Jamie resets the slide deck, we'll go ahead and get ready to do that. So if you could find your annotation tool, you're going to look at the green bar up at the top where it says you are viewing Jamie Galgana's screen. Next to that, it says view options.
This is on the floor.
So go ahead and use the drop down arrow to find the annotate tool.
Not sure where that slide went, Maria.
Okay, well, that's all right. We don't have to do that one, Jamie. We'll just go right into our activity.
Sounds
weird.
Yeah, it is strange. Well, it was essentially asking if you're a site-based or a district administrator and whether you support elementary, middle, high school, K-12, early ed, or higher ed. So if you wanted to put that information briefly in the chat, that would help us just know, oh, there it is, there's our slide. It would help us know who is in the room.
Thank you. I see some information coming in through the chat. Perfect.
Yeah.
And then, so we are still going to use our annotation tool for the next slide, though. So if you have that ready, looking at the steps on that slide, just go back 1 second, Jamie. So if you have your annotation tool ready, you're going to go ahead and select a stamp. Mm-hmm. And let's go ahead and practice that real quick. So if you grab a stamp like me and go ahead and annotate right on the screen, you'll see my green checks up here. Go ahead and practice that with me and then we'll clear before we move in. Thank you. I see some stamps coming through. Perfect.
Can you say that again?
So you'll want to go to, do you have your annotation
tool ready? Yeah, I'll put it in your bar.
So you're going to be using your annotation tool. So you're going to go up to the top of the screen where it says you're viewing Jamie Galgana's screen. Right next to that, to the right, it says view options, and then scroll down until you see the option to annotate. Select annotate, and then you should have the option to select the way you want to annotate. So I chose the stamped, along with everybody else that stamped on the screen with me. And so we're just practicing to stamp. And so it looks like Jamie cleared all those up already. And so now we're going to engage in the yellow box. So Jamie, let's clear and start over if that's okay.
Yes.
Thank you. All right, everybody. So let's try it now. So we're going to apply a stamp to every box that applies to us. So for example, I'm a district level administrator. So I'm going to select that one. I'm also I also support TK through 12. So I'm clicking that one. And I'm also a DigCit leader. So I'm putting my stamp there. So go ahead and let's see who's in the room. Take a look at who we have with us this morning. And if you are not able to access your annotation tool, no problem. Just go ahead and put it in the chat for us. Let us know what level you support, what context you work in, and if you're a DigCit leader. All right, thank you, everybody. All right, about 10 more seconds to finish up. I know we have quite a few people coming in through the chat, so thank you. I'll wait for you to add your last thought there before we move on. So it does look like we have a lot of, we don't have too many secondary educators here with us today. We do have a few district level and site-based administrators. So thank you, but we have lots of DigCit leaders with us, so thanks. All right, so we'll go ahead and clear our screen now and we'll move on to the next question. So as we think about our DigCit leader presence, we want you to think about this question. why is it important to emphasize an inclusive and equitable culture of digital citizenship? What do you think about that? Go ahead and put your stamp on either end of this scale. Is it extremely important or not at all important? Where do you find your beliefs lie? What end are you at? See a few stamps coming in. Thank you. All right. And certainly if you are not able to annotate, thank you for putting that into the chat. All right, for our next question, let's move on. We'll go ahead and clear that, Jamie, and move on to our next one. All right, on our next one, we want you to think about how frequently do you use social media for an educational digital presence? Do you never use it or do you frequently use it? Where do you fall here? Thank you. We have a range here. Okay. Mm-hmm. So welcome to our session. Those that frequently use it, we welcome your thoughts and experience on that. And if you have never used it before, we welcome your questions and your honest and open feedback as we support your learning today. All right. And lastly, we'll move on to our last question. And so think about this one. How familiar are you with your school or district's digital citizenship policies and practices? Extremely familiar or not at all familiar or somewhere in between? Thank you for engaging both in the chat and here on the screen. Perfect. I see some questions about social media. So meaning, you know, like Twitter or Instagram or even Facebook. So social media accounts, you know, where you might be sharing some information in relation to your role as an educator. So if you're not sure what that is, we will probably be clarifying that for you in just a few moments. All right, so let's jump right in. Thank you everybody for letting us know where you're at on this. And as we move forward, we're going to be using that information to help us in your learning. So at this point, I'm going to hand over to Jamie and she's going to ground us in some really foundational understandings around our DigCit LA presence.
Thank you, Maria. All right, just to give us some grounding on a little bit more about LA Unified and what we've done around digital citizenship, I wanted to provide just a really quick at a glance context of our school district. So LA Unified is the nation's second largest school district, totaling over 710 square miles, which includes most of the city of Los Angeles, along with all or portions of 25 cities and unincorporated areas around LA County. Approximately 4.8 million people are living within these boundaries, and we're really excited and happy to serve the over 1,400 schools that we have in our district from PK to adult ed. Our particular office, the Instructional Technology Initiative, is specifically tasked with designing and delivering professional learning to over 3,000 administrators and nearly 25,000 teachers, who in turn are making an impact on the life and experiences of our students of over 565,000 students across the six local districts. So all of you who are joining us from Los Angeles, you know, I applaud the work that you're doing to support our giant district. And hopefully this provides some additional context for those who are not familiar with LAUSD. And part of that digital professional learning that we do provide is digital citizenship. So to ensure all of this work is implemented across the board, it's important to have leadership that supports these efforts and frameworks as a guidance. So we do have our district 2022-2026 strategic plan that was introduced this past June. And for the next 4 years, Los Angeles Unified will be focusing on a singular goal, which is to ensure that all students are ready to graduate, ready for the world, to thrive in college, career, and life. So these five pillars each outlining four priorities as shown to the right is the strategic plan. And as the office leading digital citizenship across our schools, we were so thrilled to see that digital citizenship was a priority that was outlined in strong social emotional skills in pillar two, joy and wellness. So our strategic plan really identifies digital citizenship as a strategy with resources, outlining specific actions that we can take as a school site or as a district and community levels to advance strong social emotional skills. So we're really grateful that a lot of this work is supported and shared across the district as part of our district goals and plan. And so to give some background on how we got to where we are, we have been a department for 10 years. And let's take a moment to look at this timeline where you can see kind of where we started. So looking along the bottom, you'll see that the longest bar is our district office team. We established our district office in 2012, continued to today. So it is our 10-year anniversary this year as ITI. And soon after in 2013, we developed a social media policy for students and employees. Shortly after that, we designed the responsible and acceptable use policy. So you'll see that along the top. That's some paperwork, a policy for students to fill out to say that they'll be safe, responsible, and accept their use as they're receiving a device. And then we also began some critical partnerships that help push this work forward. And we've also started our inaugural Digital Citizenship Week, which as you see continues through today. Our very first DigCit Week celebration was at Western Avenue Elementary in 2014. So you'll see kind of the progression of our Digital Citizenship Week over the years and kind of how we've started as a department and where we are today. You'll see added on the timeline are the task force recommendations. So we brought together educators, community members, families to come together and make some recommendations on what they need around ed tech in their classrooms. And so there's a photo of people gathering. And then we adopted the ISTE standards in 2016, the ISTE standards for students. And that dramatically changed kind of the direction that we were going as a department and really helped us have the language to support schools in implementing ed tech meaningfully into instruction. And so shortly after that, we designed professional learning around each of the ISTE standards for students. That's our ISTE suite professional learning that still continues today. And we also started the process of encouraging schools to become common sense education certified schools and educators. So as you see, that's also continuing through today. And later on, the responsible use and acceptable use policy just turned to responsible use. We wanted to really switch that narrative to empower people to use technology meaningfully and not just accept that they're receiving a device. And another addition to that was adding on a family layer. So not only are students completing the responsible use policy themselves and accepting it, but they're also taking that home, having conversations with their families about how they will use technology responsibly in the classroom. We also continued to add to our professional learning catalog around digital citizenship. We started, we came up with a district definition of what digital citizenship is, which we'll look at in a moment. Really started to encourage building a digital presence. So that's what we'll talk a little bit more about today to help you get started if that's something that you want to follow up with. And then as you can see, our shortest model of support, but one that is continuing and growing is DigCit Con, which is now DigCit Connect. We started that in 2020 with AXA Region 16. We did that virtually for 2 years. And this year we were really excited that ISTE wanted to partner to make this the international conference that it is today. So all of you are attending the first ever DigCit Connect, which has built off of DigCit Con in the last 2 years, now reaching a greater audience and families and caretakers as well. So that kind of gives you an overview of our timeline with DigCit LA, but I wanted to frame it around the ISTE standards for education leaders. So as education leaders, joining this administrative session, it's important that we want to outline how we have and how you might see yourself as an equity and advocate for digital citizenship, and also how we might build systems to implement, sustain, and continually improve the use of technology to support student learning. So those are two standards from the Education Leader Standards that we hope you'll kind of keep in mind as we walk you through our process and then the next steps for you to create your digital plan. As I mentioned, we did come up with a formal definition of digital citizenship. So I'll give you a moment to read that. All right, so we've identified digital citizenship as the practice of cultivating a positive, authentic digital footprint that can be leveraged for college and career success. To share a little bit more about that layer of partnerships that I had mentioned earlier, it's so important that we don't do this work alone. So the DigCit Coalition that was mentioned earlier by Richard Culotta is a diverse group of tech, education, and media organizations hosted by ISTE, and they convened in 2019 to really engage educators, share best practices, provide tools to promote a new definition of digital citizenship and well-being. So here are some of the partners that are part of DigCit Commit, along with LA Unified School District. And from that, we also adopted the DigCit competency. So those that that Richard shared earlier about being inclusive, informed, engaged, balanced, and alert are competencies that we incorporate into our professional learning and our teaching with students around digital citizenship. Another framework that might help you understand how we've really tried to create a digital presence at the district is this framework. So we've really identified three ways that we want to have a digital presence when we're posting to social media, and that is sharing knowledge, and showing how that might translate to your current efforts, sharing resources, some work that's informing your current thinking and your work. And then we also use social media to share evidence, and you'll see a lot of that really showcasing some rigorous, relevant instructional activities around digital citizenship and our other initiatives of computer science education and the implementation of ISTE standards. And these are just some examples of things that you also might consider posting if you do have a digital presence as a district or as a site-based leader. So all of that is really just kind of a source for material. I wanted to share some examples of what this might look like and what it looks like in our practice. It's really based off of the work, insights, and the professional interests that turn into your digital presence. So an example of sharing knowledge from our Twitter handle is really sharing some of those policy reviews and revisions documents that we have. So that's sharing knowledge with our community about the policies that we've adopted and designed. Sharing evidence might, you know, one example might be recognizing the schools who have reached common sense certification. So evidence of their practice, evidence of their accomplishments around making sure students, families, and teachers are all aware and teaching digital citizenship. Another example would be sharing resources. So this is an example of sharing an article that one of our coaches had written for the California Teachers Association around digital citizenship. So these are three ways you might want to showcase how you are a DigCit leader, especially for those of you who don't have social media yet and might be, you know, a little hesitant to post and you're not sure what things to post, but you do want to have kind of a professional digital presence. Hopefully this framework might be a good guidance for you in knowing what to post. So before we do move on and start exploring materials, I wanted to share this video of one of our principals who is an equity and citizenship advocate. And if you are joining this admin session, you will see and continuing that pathway this afternoon, you'll see Principal Duran also share in his session. But I see him here in our session, might have stepped away for a second, but I wanted to share this video that we created that really shows what this looks like from a school-based perspective.
I'm Gabriel Duran. I'm the principal of Maywood Center for Enriched Studies. It's a span school, grades 6 through 12, in the southeast part of LA County. The demographics is majority, 92% Hispanic, Latino, first generation, many of them.
The digital agent program came about when the school wanted to recognize people that use social media and computer science in a positive way to make a difference in the community. And they wanted to highlight those people and encourage them to keep doing what they're doing, because in the end, it positively impacts our school.
We wanted to really see what the students were offering and what their peers had to say about who these individuals, the ones that really took the time to tell us why they should be chosen as a digital agent, were very, very detailed, and it really warms my heart every time I read them.
So I post pictures of flowers or nature. What motivates me is just to make someone feel happy, because they know, because of climate change, and we have to like remind ourselves that one day the flower might not be there, and we just might have roads and sidewalks and buildings.
I use social media platforms to share my art with other people, so I can just kind of further my presence in the art world, but also use social media to help promote what I do.
We post motivational quotes to make people feel good, because sometimes school could be really stressful, but when you open your phone and you see your feed and it's a positive quote, it makes you smile and it makes you feel happy.
You know, the pollution that has happened in this community with a battery company that had polluted many of the areas, our students have taken it on to use the technology and to get their message out. Are you aware that this has happened in our community? So they reach beyond our walls. And so because of that, they become global learners, global influencers.
You just have to know what you want to do when you get on social media, and you have to know what impact you want to make.
We are all interconnected. We are connected with kids in Australia and what's happening with the fires, just like the fires that were recently in California. So when our students access that and then say, oh yeah, you know what, they face very similar situations, let's find out what people my age think of in this, then I can reach out.
Usually when parents hear social media, they think that you're gonna, like, something inappropriate's on there, or that something bad could happen to you. You could do really good things and get noticed for those things, and you could make a difference in someone else's life.
I think it's because social media is such a big thing now, and it's a lot of, I think a lot of careers are also gonna have to be based off of the internet and social platforms. So it's good to kind of build a presence now that I'm young, so it can help me out in the future once I decide to settle for a career.
The digital citizenship is being responsible and saying, how can I connect with somebody to get information so that we can both gain? And I think with that, when you just think of it as watch out for the boogeyman, watch out for the strangers, then you are missing on the opportunity to be global learners, which is our kids are. And they will find the ways to do so, but if we can instruct them to be productive in how they access, because they will. They will find the sources, so either you teach them to, you know, interconnect it, or they will do it on their own and create their own meaning.
So I think that we have an obligation as a school community all around the country to make it part of our instruction. Like I said, it's part of our daily lives, and might as well use our platform as a school to make it a positive impact in our community.
That's something that I really focus on. Like, I wanna leave high school knowing that I did something positive with social media and computer science in general, because that's what I want to major in. And I feel like it's something so powerful, and it could truly make a difference in this world.
Right. So now that you've heard a little bit about that, let's start to explore. So I want to hand it over to Maria.
Yes, thank you, Jamie. And what a wonderful example from MESIS and Principal Duran. Thank you for joining us. I see you back. And so we really want to kind of highlight that kind of digital presence as an example of a school site, and invite you now to explore the policies in LA Unified that have informed a lot of this work. And so we're going to do a quick jigsaw activity. And so we're going to invite you to go into breakout rooms, take a look at four different policies that we have in place in LAUSD, some of which Jamie mentioned when she went over the timeline. And then you're going to just take about 3 minutes to read it and then summarize for the others in your group. So you're only reading one policy, and then you're sharing out and learning from the others in your room about the policy that they read. And so we'll have a total of 7 minutes in the breakout room, then we'll bring you back, And then we're going to move into a second activity. So as we transition, I'm going to go ahead and open the breakout rooms. You are all assigned randomly to breakout rooms. Please go ahead and get started as soon as you get in. We are a little behind on time, so just want to keep that top of mind for you. Let us know in the chat if you need any supports. We'll be here in the lobby, but I'm opening the rooms now. See you back in 7 minutes. Bye-bye.
Have fun. Oh, did we? I don't think we gave them this link.
No, let's drop it. And actually, we need to do the whole put the whole thing to the breakout room. I'll just do that right now.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you.
I was just double checking to see that everybody was placed.
Yes, I'll double check right now.
That's not what I want in there.
I think we're good. I just need to
be moved. That worked.
Let's see. Should I go around to room starting from the bottom and give them the link? I forgot to share that beforehand.
I just broadcasted it.
Okay. I don't know if it's clickable though.
Okay. Let's go. You want to start from the bottom? I'll go start from the top.
Yeah. Start from room 10. No one's in 11 because it was empty.
Wait, you're starting from where?
10.
Okay.
Because 11 was empty. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Do we have anybody here in the lobby that needs help moving into a room? Hi, Sophia.
Hi there. Sorry, I'm late. I was coming to another session.
Yes, everybody's in a breakout right now. I was just double checking.
I can wait.
Okay, they're all looking over our policies right now.
And I'll wait.
I'm going to pop into another room and double check that they're okay. I'll be right back. I just do want to check with Liana. Are you okay, Liana? Do you need help getting into a room? Liana, are you there? Hey, Jamie.
Hi. Welcome back. Hi there, welcome back. Welcome. About 30 more seconds till everyone joins us. I hope that was helpful for you to take some time to preview some of our professional learnings.
I think we only have a few people back, Jamie. We're still waiting.
Yeah, 20 more seconds. All right, we're back, Maria.
All right, welcome back, everybody. So I think we're all here. And so we hope you had an opportunity to kind of take a look at those four different examples of professional learning in LA Unified. So at this point, we're going to move forward to providing an opportunity for you to kind of look at your own digital presence. And I'm going to hand off to Jamie for this next section.
Thanks, Maria. So now that we've had just some time to explore a bit, get some grounding on what it looks like in our school district, you'll have some time to analyze yourself, your district, your school site as a DigCit leader. And we'll walk through four different areas to look at your strengths, gaps, opportunities, and considerations. So as you think about your digital presence, about your district policies or professional learning around digital citizenship, consider what some of your strengths might be in your context. Where are you currently demonstrating digital citizenship leadership? Think about some of the gaps. What parts of your identity as a DigCit leader might be missing from your digital presence? You might want to think about some opportunities to continue to amplify or build your DigCit leader presence. And there are also considerations. So you might want to consider what implications might compromise your digital presence as you're posting as a DigCit leader. So we're going to walk through really briefly what you'll be doing during your independent work time. And we want you to do a basic Google search of the words digital citizenship in quotes and your school district. So just to model that really quickly, if I open up a new tab and I typed in digital citizenship, and then in quotes, LAUSD, you'll find some all and then some news images. So you'll find our digital citizenship homepage. You'll find the responsible use policy, which maybe some of you explored, some resources for parents. So those are some of the websites that are linked as the first populated responses when you do a search of digital citizenship and LAUSD. You also might want to do an image search to see what is out there in terms of your district's digital footprint in the form of images. So clicking over on this images tab, you'll see a lot of different posts, some posters, some flyers for showcase events, some student contests, just lots of really beautiful pictures that demonstrate some of the digital citizenship activities. Looks like a newsletter cover here related to LAUSD. And then here are some of those links that popped up, our main DigCit homepage, the responsible use and our other policies and some resources. So in a moment, you will have an opportunity to do a quick Google search of your school district or even your school name and the words digital citizenship. And we are going to add in a template for you here in the chat that will help you design a digital presence plan. And you'll look at those four different areas of strengths, opportunities, gaps, and considerations. And that link takes you directly to a template. You'll just have to select this use template icon in the top right corner to make a copy of your own. But just as a quick glance, I know it's still loading, but you'll see a space for you to add your school name, the year. It has that hashtag DigCit Leader. And then on the following pages, you could choose if you want to analyze your digital presence, just what you have on social media or on the web around strengths, opportunities, gaps, considerations, and what your next steps might be. And then also noticing this frame of reference for partnerships or inclusive and equitable culture, things that you want to consider when you're identifying and when you're doing your analysis. Maybe you want to focus more on policy. So the third slide is focused around policy, where you could kind of do this deeper dive. If you wanted to look closer at just professional learning, there's a little tree map, a flea map here for you to populate your answers as you do your research. And then slides 5, 6, and 7 are just references to the framework, to the policies that you had a chance to review, and also to professional learning, just for your reference if you wanted to go back to any of that. So before we start our exploration timer, I believe we'll have, we'll do a quick 4 minutes, or is that all right, Maria? Just a little 3 minute start to get started. And then we'll come back and close out and reflect. But I wanted you to share that tool with you so you could get started.
Obviously we only have an hour together and it's just a way to get started. But I do see a few questions in the chat. So most of us are from LA Unified. So go ahead and search your school, search whatever parameters make sense for you and the digital presence that makes most sense in your context. So if you're from outside of LAUSD, you might want to look for your own individual independent school district or even your school. And if you're not finding a lot coming up, start to jot down on your digital presence plan what you find, what you don't find, and really analyze and begin to see where the gaps are, as Jamie kind of went over with the plan. So we'll let you work independently for the next few minutes, kind of search your district, your school, ask us in the chat, but let's maintain a little quiet space for everybody to kind of do that little bit of research for the next few minutes.
Sounds good.
All right, everybody. Unfortunately, an hour is just not a lot of time. And then we had a few little glitches at the beginning. So we apologize for not having as much time as we would have liked to have given you to do that research. But we hope that this is just the beginning for you to get started on really looking at your digital presence. And so we're going to go ahead and move forward now. In line with creating and being very intentional about cultivating our digital presence, we invite you to be visible about your learning today. And please tweet about what you engaged in. And we will drop that in the chat. Thank you, Jamie. And then just share about your learning today. We also want to invite you to really kind of think about the objectives that we invited you to set for your learning goal today and our question as you revisit this slide deck. You can please go back to it and utilize our digital plan to build it out. We would really hope that you might do that. And then finally, we also would like you to stay connected with us at the Instructional Technology Initiative. So here are some links to join us and check out a lot of our resources. And before we wrap up today, I would also invite everybody to give us a little feedback about today's session. We appreciate you all being here, and we'll look at your feedback as we prepare to share our learning with others going forward. Thank you so much for being here. We'll just hang out together for another couple of minutes while you fill out the evaluation. And again, we really appreciate your feedback. Thank you all for joining us today. It is, I think, 9:45, right?
Yes, it's 10:45. So 10:45. Feel free to return to the main lobby for the next section. I'll put that link in the chat as well if you aren't able to get there directly.
Bye from
Thank you so much, everyone. Bye. Happy DigCit Connect.
Thanks for joining us, everybody. Have a great one.